HIV is the cause of AIDS, a very major cause of morbidity and mortality across the world. There are more than 30 million people infected with HIV. Most of those are in the resource poor world, particularly Southern Africa. And this provides a problem because currently the treatment of choice for HIV is very expensive. It demands that infected individuals take tablets for life. There's a huge cost and there's a risk of resistance developing. The virus becomes resistant to these drugs. So in the West, in the UK for instance, HIV infected individuals can almost have a normal lifespan. It's estimated that with the treatment available, HIV is becoming a chronic disease, very manageable, and people are coming back to work and have a good life. In the resource poor world, the limitations of treatment, as I mentioned, really provide a barrier to widespread treatment. Although the WHO is now, the World Health Organization is now pushing for more and more treatment, but still more than 50% of people who need treatment are not getting treatment. There have been other attempts to try and limit the transmission of infections, in other words, to stem the rate of new infections. These include development of vaccines. These have been pretty much a failure to date, mainly because the virus mutates a lot and therefore escapes from the immune system. Other attempts to limit infection include behavioural change. Clearly, this is mainly spread by sex. And there have been some benefits in terms of education and use of condoms, but nevertheless, there still is a record number of new diagnoses in the world. So this has not worked. One of the interesting areas of prevention has been the use of treatment that I mentioned, which is treatment for an individual's benefit to try and reduce the transmission to other individuals. Treatment works by reducing the amount of viral replication in the body. In so doing, it reduces the actual amount of virus in the blood, in the genital tract, for instance, and this therefore reduces the risk of those individuals infecting others. And albeit with the limitations of cost and adherence that I mentioned earlier, there are now trials and there's great excitement as to whether antiretroviral treatment can actually be used as a mainstay of prevention as well as treatment.